Now, I want to share a little bit on the situation as of now in the church. I mean, the message. You don't have to write. You can write if you want, but it's better to listen at times, right? Yes, it's just better to listen.
Yeah.
And then, I want to go through this vision again. The vision that the Lord gave me way back in 2004. I want to go through it because there are some very important elements, aspects of that vision that are now being fulfilled. Most of you were not here when I shared it in 2004. And so in this vision, we will be able to see the timeline of events in the church. And we will also be able to see where exactly we are sitting at as a church. Now, in that vision, the Lord lifted me up. Munasikiza kweli? Unao kupande huu? So the sound is still good because they are facing the side. Munasikiza vizuri? Amen. Thank you so much. In that vision,
katika haya maono,
the Lord lifted me up and brought out, spoke to me with.
Kwa maono ambayo Bwana alinena nami
in 2004. And that vision, the different aspects of that vision are now being fulfilled. And so I need to share this with you. And then I will share on the aspect of your ministries, your lives. And then finally I intend also to share on your lives and your service to the Lord, right? So in that vision, some of you were not here when I shared that vision. You are not yet in this church. And you may not be aware of
this.
And this is a very important conversation in this ministry. That's why I want to share it right now. Now, in that vision, the Lord, that was on the 2nd of April 2004. The Lord, He lifted, it was between 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Again, between 2 p.m. and 4 p.m. And the Lord snatched me away. And then I was slain. I was on the other side of the Western Hemisphere. And when the Lord searched me, I found in that vision, when the Lord snatched me, I found myself standing right before the throne of Jehovah, right before the throne of God. And when I was standing there, I saw the tremendous glory that covered the throne of God Almighty. And when the glory covered the throne of Jehovah, He made me know that He
that sits on the throne.
Ya kuwa ambaye anaketi katika kiti cha enzi.
Yeye
aketie katika kiti cha enzi.
He made me know that he that sits on the throne of God.
Akanisababisha nijue yeye aketie katika kiti cha enzi cha Mungu.
Was seated on the throne.
Alikuwa ameketi katika kiti cha enzi.
Then he also made me know.
Yeye akanisababisha nijue
that he was paying attention to everything that was going to happen here with me here.
Ya kuwa alikuwa anatizama kwa makini sana na chochote ambacho kilikuwa kinatendeka nami hapa.
Kilikuwa kitaenda kutendeka. What was going to happen with me there?
Ambacho kitaenda kutendeka nami pale.
At the throne of God.
Katika kiti cha enzi cha Mungu.
And then all of a sudden,
kisha ghafla before,
where I was standing,
ambapo nilikuwa nimesimama,
the tremendous glory of the Lord covering the throne.
Utukufu wa ajabu wa Mungu kafunika kiti cha enzi.
Then I realized that there was a ridge.
Kisha nikatambua kulikuwa na mtaro kistari.
A small ridge.
Ilikuwa ni mtaro mdogo mchache.
That separated me from the throne of Jehovah.
Ambayo ilinitenganisha mimi na kiti cha enzi cha Yehova.
And that ridge was a bit darkish.
Na hicho kistari cha mtaro kilikuwa chenye giza hivi.
Because the glory of the throne made everything glorious.
Kwa sababu utukufu wa kiti cha enzi ulisababisha kila kitu kwa chenye utukufu.
And also everything glorious where I was standing.
Na pia kila kitu chenye utukufu ambapo nilikuwa nimesimama.
But then the reed was darkish.
Lakini huo mtaro ulikuwa wenye giza giza.
And then all of a sudden,
kisha ghafla,
John the Baptist stood on my right hand side.
Yohana Mbatizaji akasimama katika mkono wangu wa kulia.
And when John the Baptist stood on my right hand side,
ambapo Yohana Mbatizaji alisimama katika mkono wangu wa kulia,
I was still paying attention to the throne.
Bado nilikuwa nimelenga kwa makinifu kwa kiti cha enzi.
Then he began to talk to me.
Akaanza kuninenea kuniongelesha.
From the right hand side.
Kutoka katika mkono wa kulia.
And then he said,
kisha akasema,
amen. That is where the Lord will bless you, will heal you, okay? So at the throne of God, so when John the Baptist began to speak with me, he began, I was paying attention to the throne. And then he appeared on my right hand side. And then he began to speak with me. Then I had to turn and pay attention to him. And the Lord again.
Tena.
The Lord again.
Bwana tena.
As I began to speak with John the Baptist.
Nilipoanza kunena na Yohana Mbatizaji.
The Lord again.
Bwana tena.
What is the problem now? He began to speak with me.
Wakati Yohana Mbatizaji alianza kunena nami.
Then the Lord again.
Kisha Bwana tena.
Made me know.
Akanisababisha nijue.
That he was paying attention from inside the glory of the throne.
Ya kuwa alikuwa amemakinika toka ndani ya utukufu wa kiti cha enzi.
To this conversation.
Kwa haya majadiliano.
So when John the Baptist began to speak with me.
Hivyo basi wakati Yohana Mbatizaji alianza kunena nami.
He began to tell me about the Lamb of God.
Alianza kunena nami kuhusu mwana kondoo wa Mungu.
The Lamb of God that was slain for the sins of men.
Mwana kondoo wa Mungu ambaye alichinjwa kwa ajili ya dhambi za mwanadamu.
And so when he was talking with me.
Hivyo basi alipokuwa akinena nami.
I started asking him.
Nikaanza kumuuliza yeye.
Some questions.
Maswali fulani.
Because at that very time.
Kwa kuwa wakati huo haswa.
I don't know why.
Sijui kwa nini.
In that vision.
Katika haya maono.
I did not understand.
Sikuelewa.
I did not understand why.
Sikuelewa ni kwa nini.
The Lamb of God had to be slain.
Mwana kondoo wa Mungu ilibidi achinjwe.
Then immediately,
hivyo basi ghafla,
I saw another vision inside this vision.
Nikaona maono mengine ndani ya haya maono.
Then I saw the day the Lamb of God was slain on the cross.
Kisha nikaona ile siku ambayo mwana kondoo wa Mungu alichinjwa pale msalabani.
And then I saw so much blood flowing over him. I cannot share the other details, but I can only say in generic form.
Kisha nikaona damu nyingi sana ambayo inamturuzuka. Siwezi nikaelezea vilevengege vidani. Nashiriki tu kwa kijuujuu.
But I saw blood flowing when he had been slain.
Lakini niliona damu iliyotiririka alipochinjwa.
And then from the cross.
Kisha toka msalabani.
He looked at me.
Akaniangalia mimi.
And he looked from far like this.
Na akatazama kutoka mbali namna hii.
To confirm what John was saying.
kudhihirisha kudhibitisha ambayo Yohana alikuwa akisema.
And when he looked,
na alipotizama,
that is now a vision within this vision.
Hiyo sasa ni maono ndani ya haya maono.
When he looked at me,
aliponiangalia mimi,
my heart was struck.
Moyo wangu ukapigika.
Because I was arguing with John.
Kwa sababu nilikuwa nasemezana na Yohana.
I was asking him, why did he have to be slain?
Nilikuwa namuuliza mbona akachinjwa?
Why?
Kwa nini?
And so when he, I saw now the vision within the vision.
Ile basi nilipoona yale maono yaliyo ndani ya maono mengine.
Of the day he was slain.
Ile siku ambayo alichinjwa.
Then he looked at me from there.
Kisha akanitazama mimi kutoka pale.
With so much blood.
Huku akiwa na damu nyingi sana.
And the look, let me describe to you.
Na wewe mtizamo, wacha niwaelezeni.
The look was like.
Mtizamo ulikuwa kama
hapa. It was like this.
Ulikuwa namna hii.
Will you agree to do it?
Je, utakubali kuitenda?
That was the look.
Wote ulikuwa mtizamo.
Because as in, I am confirming what John is saying.
Ni kwa sababu ikana kwamba anasema ninathibitisha yale Yohana anasema.
He was saying, I am confirm, if I see from the look, he was saying, I am confirming that what John is telling me is true.
Nikitizama katika mtizamo wake, alikuwa anasema akithibitisha yale Yohana anasema ni kweli.
Yes, I was slain for the sins of man.
Ndio nilichinjwa kwa ajili ya dhambi za mwanadamu.
But the look,
lakini ule mtizamo,
when my eye caught his eye,
ambapo jicho langu lipata jicho lake,
will you accept to do it?
Je, utakubali kuitenda?
In other words, will you do it for me?
Kwa maneno mengine, utaifanya kwa ajili yangu?
And then in this conversation,
kisha katika haya majadiliano,
when I asked John, why did he have to be slain?
Nilipouliza Yohana, mbona ikabidi achinjwe?
Then John said,
Yohana akasema,
don't worry.
Usisumbuke.
It was the Father's will that he be slain.
Ilikuwa ni mapenzi ya Baba yeye achinjwe.
And he said,
kisha akasema,
the Lamb of God,
ya kwamba mwana kondoo wa Mungu,
who died for the sins of men,
aliyefia dhambi za mwanadamu,
is about to come back.
Itaribu kurudi.
For the church.
Kwa ajili ya kanisa.
So you go tell the church.
Hivyo basi wewe enda uliambia kanisa.
To prepare the way.
Liandae njia.
For the coming of the Messiah.
Kwa kuja kwa Mesihi.
And so you see that was the conversation there.
Hivyo basi wanaoja mkomba jadileno pale.
And then immediately.
Kisha mara moja.
The voice said.
Sauti ikasema.
From the throne.
Kutoka kwenye kiti cha enzi.
Let me show you.
Wacha nikuonyeshe.
The things that are about to happen.
Yale mambo ambayo hivi karibuni yatatendeka.
And from this place here.
Hivyo basi kutoka mahali hapa.
Before the throne of God.
Mbele ya kiti cha enzi cha Mungu.
I was lifted up.
Nikainuliwa juu.
And the Lord took me all over Israel.
Na Bwana akanipeleka kote kote kwenye Israeli.
And the Middle East.
Na pia kule katikati Middle East.
And it was at night.
Na ilikuwa usiku.
Because I saw the lamps, the light in the houses from above. From above I could see the lamps in the homes, the light in the homes.
Kwa sababu kutoka huku juu niliona zile taa ambazo zimewakisha kwenye nyumba, mwanga, nuru.
So it was night, though I could see the light.
Hivyo basi ilikuwa ni usiku, ningeweza kuona ile nuru.
I could see the light that was lit in every home.
Ningeona nuru ya taa ambazo zilikuwa zimewakisha katika kila boma.
Now listen to this.
Sasa sikiza haya.
When the Lord brought me the promise to Israel,
ambapo Bwana alinileta Israeli,
then he showed me the tomb of Arafat.
Kisha akanionyesha kaburi ya Arafat.
Remember that time Arafat was alive.
Kukumbuka wakati huo Arafat alikuwa hajakufa.
He was still alive.
Bado alikuwa hai.
Then he showed me the tomb, it was a big tomb.
Kisha akanionyesha kaburi, ilikuwa ni kubwa sana.
Big tomb like from the ground like this.
Kaburi kubwa kutoka chini ilikuwa kiasi kama hiki.
And it was long like this, but going like this and going like that, but long.
Ilikuwa refu namna hii, lakini huku ilikuwa inateremka namna hii na namna hii pande nyingine.
And then he took me all over the Arab world.
Kisha akanipeleka kote kote kwenye ulimwengu wa Uarabu, Uarabuni.
With light every home, it was in the night.
Kukiwa na taa na taa kila nyumba, ilikuwa ni usiku.
And they were doing this.
Alikuwa akifanya hivi.
They were mourning.
Huku alikuwa anaomboleza.
Every home there was mourning all over the land.
Kila boma kulikuwa na kuomboleza kote kote kwenye jiji hilo.
All over the Arab world there were mourning.
kote walikuwa wanamuuliza.
From above I could see, I could hear them.
Kutoka juu ningeweza kuona, ningeweza kuwasikia.
And then after that,
kisha baada hayo,
I came back again before the throne of the Lord.
Nikarudi mara tena mbele ya kiti cha enzi cha Bwana.
And realized that John was still standing here.
Na nikatambua kwamba Yohana bado alikuwa amesimama pale.
Now listen to this again.
Sasa sikia haya tena.
Then immediately,
basi ghafla,
the Lord again lifted me up.
Bwana mara tena akaniinua juu.
And when he lifted me up,
na aliponiinua juu,
I saw aircrafts.
Nikaona ndege.
I saw aircrafts full of Christians.
Nikaona ndege ambazo zimejawa na Wakristo.
And they were going to Israel.
Na zilikuwa zaenda Israeli.
A lot of aircrafts, the cloud, I saw them going, the planes were going, you know.
Zilikuwa ndege nyingi sana kwenye mawingu zilikuwa zinaenda. Waona nilikuwa naona zikienda.
And they told me they are going to Israel.
Kisha akaniambia zinaenda Israeli.
A large number of aircrafts going to Israel.
Wingi wa idadi ya ndege ambazo zinaenda Israeli.
I saw a large number of aircrafts going to Israel with Christians.
Hivyo idadi ya wingi sana ya ndege zikienda Israel huku zimebeba Wakristo.
How did I know they are Christians?
Ni vipi nilijua basi walikuwa Wakristo?
The Lord put in there some Christians so I could see. You know, I was in the cloud up so I could see. But I could see Christians inside the aircraft. The people, some people I know, I won't mention the names.
Bwana aliweka ndani pale Wakristo ambao ninawajua. Sitataja majina yao ili niweze kujua wao ni Wakristo.
They were going to Israel.
Walikuwa kwenda Israeli.
And then after that,
hivyo basi baada hayo,
again I came back.
Tena nikarudi.
And I found myself standing before John.
Na nikajipata nimesimama mbele ya Yohana.
And then at that moment,
basi wakati huo,
John the Baptist,
Yohana Batizaji,
his raiment,
vazi lake joho,
became glorious.
Ilikuwa lenye utukufu zaidi.
Very glorious.
Lenye utukufu sana.
And when I looked at his raiment becoming so glorious.
Na nilipotazama joho lake lifanyika lenye utukufu zaidi hivyo.
Then I saw even the cross there become more glorious.
Nikaona tayari pale pia imefanyika lenye utukufu zaidi.
But when I looked at my garment.
Lakini nilipotazama vazi langu pia.
Then I found that even my garment had been transfigured.
Nikapata hiyo vazi langu lilikuwa limebadilishwa.
And it became extremely glorious.
Na ikawa lenye utukufu zaidi.
And then the Lord again lifted me from there.
Kisha mara tena Bwana akaniinua kutoka pale.
And took me to Israel.
Akanipeleka Israeli.
And when I reached Israel.
Nilipofika Israeli.
Then now I saw.
Basi sasa nikaona.
Two changes of leadership in Israel.
Mbadiliko mara mbili ya uongozi Israeli.
I saw two changes of leadership in Israel.
Nikaona mbadiliko mara mbili ya uongozi Israeli.
Two changes of government.
Ni mbadiliko mara mbili wa serikali.
The first change I saw.
Mbadiliko wa kwanza ambao niliona.
And then I saw now the second change.
Kisha sasa nikaona mbadiliko wa pili.
But when the second change took place.
Lakini sasa wakati mbadiliko wa pili utendeka.
Then the Lord now opened my eyes. I saw the whole earth.
Kisha sasa Bwana akafungua macho yangu nikaona ulimwengu wote.
And when I saw the whole earth.
Nikaona ulimwengu wote.
I saw that the whole earth was shocked.
Niliona ulimwengu wote ulikuwa umeshtushwa.
By the second change, not the first, the second change.
Na mbadiliko wa pili, sio kwanza, mbadiliko wa pili.
Of leadership in Israel.
Au uongozi Israeli.
Why were they shocked?
Kwa nini walishtushwa?
Because this was now a right-wing government.
Kwa kuwa sasa hii ilikuwa ni serikali yenye mlengo wa kulia.
The word is not extremist. It's just the leaning to the right.
Ni kuegemea tu upande wa kulia.
It was a right government, right-wing government.
Ilikuwa ni serikali yenye mlengo wa kulia.
And so the whole earth was panicking.
Hivyo basi ulimwengu wote ulikuwa washtuka.
And they were.
Na walikuwa nalia.
The whole earth will say, how will we now negotiate with them?
Dunia yote ilikuwa inasema, vipi sasa tutaweza kuhojiana, kuongea na wao?
How will we negotiate with them for the peace in Palestine?
Ni vipi tutaweza kusemezana nao kuhusu amani kule Palestine?
So there was a panic in the entire world.
Hivyo basi kulikuwa na uoga, mshtuko ulimwengu wote.
Because of this second change.
Kwa sababu huu mbadiliko wa pili.
And when I saw the second change,
nilipoona mbadiliko wa pili,
I realized,
nilitambua,
that second change,
ya kwamba huo mbadiliko wa pili,
was going to Benjamin Netanyahu too.
Ulikuwa unaenda kwa Benjamin Netanyahu wa pili.
Remember when I was in Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu was the prime minister. I was there during Yitzhak Rabin. Until he was assassinated, as we were just watching TV like this. We were watching TV when he was assassinated that night, that evening. And then now I saw the reign of Benjamin Netanyahu when I was there. And so when I realized that this Benjamin Netanyahu was coming, this would be Benjamin Netanyahu too. Netanyahu too, yes. And so this change troubled the earth. And the whole world was troubled. How will we negotiate with them for the Palestinian peace? And then after that, then again I found myself standing right next to John the Baptist. So you can see that those were visions within the vision. And then you see immediately John the Baptist, when he realized I have arrived here. After the second change of government took place in Israel, then John the Baptist said, behold the Lamb of God.
Tazama mwana kondoo wa Mungu.
He comes for the church.
Analijia kanisa.
And I saw from the glory of the Lord.
Nikaona kutoka katika utukufu wa Bwana.
That covered the throne of God.
Ambaye alifunika kiti cha enzi cha Mungu.
Now the precious, most powerful.
Sasa yenye nguvu ya damani zaidi.
I said the precious, most powerful.
Ya damani yenye nguvu zaidi.
Most glorious Lamb of God. I saw him now leave from the throne of God. And he came. And when the Lamb of God came, everything was glorious here before. But everything became more glorious. So as he was coming, there was more glory. You could see the zone where he has reached and where we were. That more glorious as was coming. There was so much glory. Much more glorious. And then he came all the way. And then when I don't want to share a little bit, but let's stop there. I cannot share a little more than that now. When he arrived. But then after that, I woke up from this mighty conversation. I want to share a little bit on that now. You see? Because I know almost all of you have not heard this. Now listen to this. Then I began going all over the world saying that Yasser Arafat will die soon.
Yasser Arafat.
Yes, thank you so much that he is going to die soon. And you know, all over the world. Until
pale,
one time in the news they started saying he is not feeling well.
Siku moja katika vyombo vya habari wakaanza kusema yeye hasikii vyema katika mwili.
I even arrived in Kenya here and I preached it at Kayole.
Nilifika hapa Kenya na nikahubiri kule Kayole.
The first church I preached in.
Kanisa la kwanza ambapo nilihubiri.
Belonging to a lady, she was a lady.
Ilikuwa ni mwanamke.
And she it was just a house, small one room, the room like this space. With about 7 people, and she was there. She invited me, come bring the message of Jehovah. That's the first church I preached in this land. And at that place, I get this conversation.
Nilitoa haya majadiliano.
The prophecies.
Zile unabii.
And I said, Yasser Arafat is going to die soon.
And nikasema, Yasser Arafat atakufa hivi karibuni.
I have seen his tomb.
Nimeona kaburi yake.
And so, you know, I went all over the world saying this.
Ibabasi kote kote duniani kwa kisema hivi.
Then one time he became sick. And then one time pastors began to call me, if you can understand a bit. So pastors began to call me all over, from all over the world. And sending emails. And then they said, man of God, have you watched the news? Yes, sir, Arafat has died.
Yes, sir, Arafat amekufa.
So when I went to watch news, then I found that he has died. Then I realized the first prophecy has been fulfilled in this prophecy. And then things went on. On and on. And then after some time, there was Ariel Sharon. Ariel Sharon.
Ariel Sharon.
Yes, that's the Prime Minister of Israel.
Ambaye ni waziri mkuu wa Israeli.
And so, you know, Ariel Sharon is the one that sent the Israeli tanks.
Unajua Ariel Sharon ndiye alikuwa anatuma magari ya vita Israeli.
And sent the tanks, the armored tanks into southern Lebanon.
Kutuma hiyo magari ya vita kule southern Lebanon.
To take over the territory because it was being used by terrorists as a launching pad.
Ili kuchukua ushukani kwa sababu ilikuwa inatumiwa na wapigaji vita. Wasi.
To attack Israel.
Kuipiga Israel.
Listen very, very, very carefully because today is your day to mature up a little bit, right?
Basi kasikiza kimakini kabisa kwa sababu hii siku yako kukomaa kidogo.
That's why you come. When you come, I have to give you this, right?
Ndio unakuja ukija lazima nikupe haya, sawa?
Because I know you're not getting anywhere else. Thank you so much. So now, so Ariel Sharon, who was the head of the army before, had sent the Israeli tanks and they had captured southern
Lebanon.
Because of Hezbollah attacking
Israel.
Now Ariel Sharon later became the Prime Minister of
Israel.
Now, after some time, Ariel Sharon wanted to give some part of Jerusalem. He wanted to negotiate with them. He began to negotiate with them. They went to
Washington.
And then he was saying that we need to divide Jerusalem and what all this, you know. And then Ariel Sharon became sick.
Kisha Ariel Sharon akakuwa mgonjwa.
And he went into a coma.
Na pia akapoteza fahamu kabisa.
Until today.
Hadi wa leo.
He's in hospital being supported by machines.
Yuko kwenye hospitali anapata ufadhili wa mashine tu.
Until this day to speak.
Hadi wa leo tunaponena.
But listen to this.
Lakini sikiza haya.
After Ariel Sharon. Then came Ehud Olmert. Then I realized that is the first change. Ehud Olmert used to be the mayor of Jerusalem.
Ehud Olmert.
He used to be the mayor of Jerusalem. Now he became the prime minister.
Sasa akafanyika waziri mkuu.
And then.
Kisha.
Time went on.
Wakati ukaendelea na kuendelea.
And then I saw that Ehud Olmert is becoming sick, prostate cancer.
Nikaona Ehud Olmert anakuwa mgonjwa, anakuwa na saratani ya sehemu za siri.
And so that was developing.
Basi hiyo ilikuwa inaendelea.
But in between.
Lakini hapo katikati.
That's around 2008 now.
Na ilikuwa yapata mwaka 2008 sasa.
In between.
Hapo katikati.
When 2008 arrived.
Wakati mwaka 2008 ulifika.
Israel was celebrating 60 years since her birth.
Israel ilikuwa yasherekea miaka 60 baada ya kuzaliwa kwake.
Tangu kuzaliwa. 60 years since her birth.
Miaka 60 tangu kuzaliwa kwake.
And then, because Israel was born in 1948, right? So Christians began to live from all over the world. And then I checked the Israeli news.
Nikatizama habari kule Israeli.
And they said,
what sema?
Never since the nation of Israel was created.
Kamwe tangu nje Israeli kuanzishwa.
Never have many planes landing in Tel Aviv. Landing. Almost every 2 minutes a plane is landing. It's landing.
Kila yapata dakika 2 ni ndege inatua. Haijafika ndege nyingi kiasi hicho.
So many planes were landing in Tel Aviv, much more than they had ever seen since they began the state of Israel.
Basi ndege nyingi zilikuwa zinatua Tel Aviv tangu baada walipoanzisha nchi Israeli.
They had never seen that before.
Hajaiona hayo hapo awali.
They were saying the traffic of aircraft is too much. They are now trying to cope with it. The Christians were coming out, they were having chartered flights, commercial flights, all types of flights. Chartered flights.
Ndege za kibinafsi,
commercial, all flights were full headed to Israel.
Na ndege za kibiashara zote zilikuwa zimejaa zikienda Israeli.
Now listen to this.
Sasa sikiza haya.
The book of Isaiah chapter 60.
Kitabu cha
Isaiah. Book of Isaiah chapter 60.
Kitabu cha Isaiah mlango wake wa 60.
60. Once you are in Isaiah 60,
okay, fika Isaiah 60.
Let me know.
Nijulishe.
It's amazing. I'm going to read 4 versions here.
Inashangaza, naenda kusoma tafsiri nne hapa.
Now the second prophecy.
Sasa unabii wa pili.
Inside that conversation. When I saw so many Christians in aircrafts going to
Israel.
So the Lord had shown Isaiah also that conversation. Isaiah chapter 60 verse
8.
I am going to read from King James. And then I'll read Amplified. A New American Standard. And then NIV. So listen to what he says here. In King James he says, Isaiah 60 verse
8.
He says, who are these that fly as a cloud and as the doves to their windows?
Nani hawa warukao kama mawingu na kama huwa kuelekea kwenye viota vyao?
Amplified says,
tafsiri Amplified inasema,
who are these who fly like a cloud and like doves to their windows?
Nikina nani hawa ambao wanaruka kama mawingu na kama huwa kwenye dirisha zao?
New American Standard says,
New American Standard inasema,
who are these who fly like a cloud and like the doves to their lattices?
Nikina nani hawa ambao wanaruka kama huwa na kama mawingu katika viota vyao?
It's very powerful. Thank you so much. And then I'm reading now NIV.
Sasa nasoma NIV.
Who are these that fly along like clouds, like doves to their nests?
Nikina nani hawa wanaenda kama mawingu na kama huwa kwenye viota vyao?
Now remember this.
Sasa kumbuka hawa.
When the Lord was showing Isaiah this,
ambapo Bwana alikuwa anamuonyesha Isaiah haya,
he made sure, you know, when the Lord speaks to you in a vision,
alihakikisha, unajua wakati Bwana anena nawe katika maono,
every time he speaks with his servant,
kila wakati ananena na utumishi wake,
he also puts a message in your heart to understand what he's talking about.
Pia anaweka ujumbe katika moyo wako kaweza kuelewa ni nini anazungumzia.
So when he spoke to Isaiah about this,
hivyo basi aliponena na Isaiah kuhusu haya,
he made Isaiah know that these were not Israel.
Alisababisha Isaiah aelewe kwa hawa wako wa Israeli.
And that's why Isaiah now asked the Lord.
Ndio sasa Isaiah akamuuliza Bwana,
who are these that fly like a cloud?
Ni kina nani hao ambao wanaruka kama mawingu?
Like doves to their windows.
Kama huwa kwenye viota vyao.
Remember at that time the aircraft had not been created.
Ukumbuke wakati huo ndege haikuwa imeundwa.
The aeroplane had not been created.
Ndege hazikuwa zimeundwa.
Had not been invented.
Hazikuwa zimetambuliwa, zikavumbuliwa.
And so Isaiah was describing the event that later the Lord comes to talk to me about.
Hivyo basi Isaiah alikuwa akielezea tukio ambalo baadaye Bwana alikuja kulizungumzia.
And Isaiah saw them in the clouds.
Na Isaiah aliona wao kwenye mawingu.
In the NIV he says.
Katika NIV anasema.
Like doves to their nests.
Ni kama huwa kwa viota vyao.
They're flying with the cloud.
Wanaruka pamoja na mawingu.
With those of you, if you're in the aircraft, you know this, right?
Okay.
Because you normally see the clouds also flying, you know. Sometimes going that way, sometimes going in the opposite direction, or going, you see the clouds also flying as the plane is flying, you know.
Wanaona mawingu yakiruka, jinsi ndege inaruka pia.
Mawingu is the cloud?
Yeah, mawingu.
Yes, nube in Spanish. Eh? Okay. So you see that the clouds also fly, because when you watch they fly. Normally when I travel with my team, I tell them, look through the window, look what Isaiah saw. Normally I tell them, look, the clouds are also flying. So Isaiah saw the aircraft before it was invented.
Hivyo basi Isaya aliona ndege kabla haijavumbuliwa.
And he realized that these were not Israelites.
Na yeye alitambua hawa walikuwa si Waisraeli.
That these ones actually were not Israelites, but they were going to Israel.
Hawa hakika hawakuwa ni Waisraeli, lakini walikuwa waenenda Israeli.
So you remember in this conversation when I said time is coming, I was going all over the world.
Hivyo basi utakumbuka katika hapo nikisema nikienda kote kote ulimwenguni.
For 4 years.
Kwa miaka minne.
All over the earth.
Kote kote.
And I was saying that very soon many Christians will go to Israel. I see a lot of Christians going to
Israel
until come 2008. Then I was shocked that prophecy was fulfilled. Thank you for clapping. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. You that clapped the Lord. There's a young man in our table. Where was that young man that clapped first? Yes. Thank you so much. I've blessed you eternally. Thank you so much. And all of you. Thank you. Because you, thank you so much. So listen to this. The second prophecy was fulfilled. And then,
Kisha,
come 2009. Then Benjamin Netanyahu became the Prime Minister of Israel.
Benjamin Netanyahu akafanyika waziri mkuu wa Israeli.
So listen to these precious people. Now,
sasa,
the second prophecy is now fulfilled.
Unabii wa pili sasa umetimizwa.
And then now, 2009, I think it was January or whatever, Benjamin Netanyahu became Prime Minister of Israel again.
Sasa mwaka 2009 naona ilikuwa ni Januari hivi Benjamin Netanyahu kafanyika waziri mkuu wa Israeli mara ya pili.
That became Benjamin Netanyahu too.
Sasa hiyo ikakuwa ni Benjamin Netanyahu ya pili.
And then also Avigdor Lieberman became the foreign minister, the minister for foreign affairs of Israel.
Akafanyika waziri ya mambo za nchi za kigeni wa Israeli.
And Avigdor Lieberman he came from the Russian diaspora.
Alitoka katika maeneo ya India ya kule Russia.
So the Russian diaspora that came to Israel.
Hivyo basi watu kutoka maeneo ya huko Israel walikuja walitoka Russia walikuja Israeli.
They said Palestinians should be swept out.
Walisema wa Palestina wanafaa kuondolewa kabisa kamilifu.
And even
na hata
even the Israeli Arabs, you know there are some Arabs inside Israel.
Na hata wa Israeli ambao ni Waarabu, unajua kuna Waarabu ambao wako ndani Israeli.
They are Israeli citizens.
Ambao ni raia wa Israeli.
There are two types.
Kuna aina mbili.
We are the Druze people.
Kuna watu wa Druze.
The Druze people, they spread all over the Middle East.
Watu wa Druze wako kwa maeneo yote ya Middle East.
And in every country they are in, they always become allegiant, very loyal to that nation, to the authority.
Na kwa taifa lote wanakuwa waaminifu sana, wanyenyekevu kwa mamlaka ya nchi hiyo.
In Israel, only the Jewish people can go to the Israeli army, the IDF.
Kwa kule Israeli ni watu wa Yahudi pekee ambao wanaweza kwenda katika jeshi Israeli IDF.
In fact, everybody goes to the army, the girls, the boys, everybody is a soldier in Israel.
Kila mtu anaenda kwa jeshi, wasichana, vijana, kila mtu ni askari kule Israeli.
And so in Israel,
basi Israeli,
because the Druze people are faithful to the authority.
Kwa sababu wa Druze, watu wa Druze ni waaminifu sana kwa mamlaka.
The Druze Arabs.
Waarabu ambao ni Druze,
because they are faithful to the authority.
Kwa sababu wao ni waaminifu sana kwa mamlaka.
You see them also now accepted in the army.
Unaona sasa nao wanakubalika kwenye jeshi.
And so they go there as scouters, the ones that do the scouting and all that, they go to the army.
Wanaenda pale kama kwenye majasusi ambao wanaingia kwenye jeshi.
But then the other Israeli Arabs are not allowed.
Lakini wale wengine ambao ni Waarabu Israeli hawaruhusiwi.
But their sisters, they are ID.
Lakini wale raia wako na kitambulisho.
And on this other side you have the Palestinians now.
Na upande mwingine kuna Palestini sasa.
Now listen very carefully.
Sasa sikiza kwa makinifu.
Avigdor Lieberman when he came from the Russian party, it is called the Russian political party in Israel.
Alipotoka katika chama cha kisiasa ambacho cha Russia kule Israel.
Cha Urusi.
Cha wale wa Urusi Israeli.
The Russian Jews.
Ambao ni Wayahudi wa Urusi.
They said.
Wakasema.
When they come to power.
Watakapopata mamlaka.
They will clean up the Israeli Arabs.
Watasafisha waondoe kabisa wa Israeli na Waarabu.
Chase them from Israel.
Na wafukuze kutoka Israeli.
And the Druze will clean out and chase them.
Na Wadruze watawasafisha wafukuze.
And then Palestinians will chase them also from that place wherever they stay.
And pia watafukuza Palestina popote ambapo wanaishi.
So when Benjamin Netanyahu came to power.
Hivyo basi wakati Benjamin Netanyahu alipata mamlaka.
Because of the nature of the Israeli politics.
Kwa sababu ya asili ya siasa za kule Israeli.
He needed a coalition to be able to form a government.
Alihitaji umoja wa vyama ili kuweza kuunda serikali.
And then his Likud party.
Na chama chake cha Likud.
Made an alliance now with the Russian party.
Kikafanya makubaliano ya umoja na hicho chama cha Urusi.
And then they could now have the majority to form a government.
Hivyo basi wakakuwa na wengi wa watu wa msemo kwenye serikali.
Now the whole world was shocked.
Sasa ulimwengu wote ukashangazwa.
When Avigdor Lieberman became the Israeli Minister for Foreign Affairs.
Ambapo Avigdor Lieberman alifanyika waziri wa mambo ya kigeni wa Israeli.
The whole world was shocked.
Dunia yote ikashangazwa.
When Avigdor Lieberman became the Israeli Foreign Affairs.
Wakati Avigdor Lieberman alifanyika waziri wa mambo ya kigeni ya Israeli.
And so they were saying, but how will we negotiate with them in that condition?
Wakasema tutaweza kujisajili kusema nao namna gani katika hiyo hali?
Nobody. So listen, precious people.
Basi sikieni watu wa thamani.
That was now what the Lord showed me in that conversation in 2004.
Hiyo sasa ndio Bwana alinionyesha katika mazungumzo ya mwaka 2004.
How will we be able to now negotiate with them for the Palestinian peace?
Tutawezaje kujadiliana na hao kuhusu amani ya Israeli?
So you see that?
Waona hayo.
But one thing I want to draw your attention to.
Lakini kitu moja ambacho ningependa kuvuta makinifu yenu kwake.
When there was going to be a change in the leadership.
Ambapo kulienda kuwa na mabadiliko katika uongozi.
In Israel.
Kule Israeli.
Inside the vision.
Ndani pale katika maono.
Standing before the throne of God.
Nikisimama mbele ya kiti cha enzi cha Mungu.
John the Baptist.
Yohana Mbatizaji.
His raiment.
Joho lake.
His vazi lake.
Vazi lake.
Became super glorious.
Likawa na utukufu kupita kiasi.
And then.
Kisha.
Even around him became much more glorious.
Hata kuzunguka kwake ikawa na utukufu tena zaidi.
And then when I looked at my garment.
Hivyo basi nilipotizama vazi langu.
I realized I had also been transfigured.
Nilitambua kuwa pia mimi
and everything became super glorious. Now look at that. And then came now the second change. And then when the second change took place. And I came. And stood before John the Baptist again. Then he said. Behold the Lamb of God. It is coming. I want you to understand the message there, the hidden secret here. I think you got it already.
Yes.
So you see that the garments stand totally super glorious. And then the lamb came. Then the reed that was darkish disappeared. And everything became super, super, super glorious. What is the message you think? What is the message you
think?
This is the time for the glorious garment. Do you understand? Because the prophecy on Benjamin Netanyahu too has been fulfilled. In the web, some people were discussing this. They were saying, but the Lord spoke to his servant. That when the Benjamin Netanyahu comes into power, during his reign,
wakati wa utawala wake,
then Messiah will come. Then I said, no, that is a lie. I think I made it clear on the radio, right?
No, I
did not handle that part, yes. But I made it clear later. Because I said, when Benjamin Netanyahu came to throne, then I came back here. And John the Baptist said, behold the Lamb of God. And the glory opened. And the super glorious Lamb of God. The most powerful Lamb of God. The mightiest Lamb of God. Came from there. So I did not say during. And I cannot rule out during. I did not say after. And I cannot rule out after. Nobody knows the day or the hour of the coming of the Messiah. Do you understand? But I've shared with you secrets here that tells you the time is over. The secret is here. That when Benjamin Netanyahu takes place, remember before Benjamin Netanyahu came, my garment became super glorious. And I went to Israel. You see that? And when I went there, I went with a glorious garment. Super glorious. Listen to this. And then came back here. And then listened to the conversation on the coming of the Lamb now. This is the time to prepare for the coming of the Messiah. You can see here the timeline of the Lord. The time is over. If you tie it to the Iranian war, if you tie it to the Iranian one, then you know the time is over. Like I said, the Iranian war will make sure that Israel will need peace. You cannot, let me tell you one thing, you cannot sign peace until you go to war. No, you will not sign peace until you will be crazy. You go to Tanzania. And tell them Tanzania. You know our relationship is so good, eh? It's so peaceful. But I think we should sign a peace treaty. They will refuse, they say no. We want war. You see that? So the war that is coming to Iran. I have seen every detail. The Lord takes me, I sit among the Israeli defense forces, the chiefs of the army. And always we hear, we work together on the planning. I get involved when I wake up, I'm very shocked about this also. I have seen the aircrafts go, I saw them come back safe. And so that war will cause Israel to need peace. It will also cause the other nations around Israel to need peace. Because with the kind of fire I see, I think it's a nuclear weapon that is used. I think the two missiles I see, I think those are nuclear missiles, because when they hit the facility, they totally devastate the facility. And then after that, the peace treaty. Now, for 7 years. Or 3.5. But let's 7 years peace. And then the 3.5 are more critical. But the 7 year peace deal, right?
Kisha hiyo tatu na nusu ni muhimu zaidi, lakini sasa ile miaka saba kubaliana.
The false peace.
Amani ya uongo.
And you know who signs a false treaty with Israel?
Na unajua ni nani anatia mkataba badia uongo na Israeli?
So that tells you that the church is not here.
Hivyo basi anakuambia kanisa limo hapa tena.
Halitakuwa hapa.
Halitakuwa hapa.
Oh, that's very powerful, so we're changing that. Yes, we'll not be here.
Kanisa halitakuwa hapa.
At all at the time.
Kabisa wakati huo.
Now, considering that that is, I need to finish, considering that that is the condition of the timeline of the Lord, then what is the message to you, the church in
Nairobi?
Focus on me, don't write. Yesterday I saw a dream about the church when I was coming,
kuhusu kanisa nilipokuwa naja,
which I'm going to share briefly.
Ambao nitashiriki kwa ufupi.
I saw the shoe.
Niliona kiatu.
Is torn.
Kimeharibika.
Again, let me begin from square one. I saw the pastors remove their shoes.
Niliona wachungaji wamadoa viatu vyao.
And remove the socks.
Atia kutoa socks.
Then they put them somewhere.
Wakazika mahali.
After that.
Baada hayo.
They went.
Walienda.
But when they came back.
Lakini waliporudi.
I saw the shoes were torn.
Niliona kiatu kilikuwa kimeraruka.
The somewhere here.
Upande huo hapa.
And in front.
Na pia mbele.
And the vidole were being seen touching on soil. In front, and this side was torn. Yesterday.
Jana.
I saw that.
Niliona hayo.
I have received you here in the name of the Lord. Don't clap. I would not clap if I was you. I've received you here in the name of the Lord. But
lakini,
I have to stand with the Lord.
Itabidi nisimame naye Bwana.
Only the Lord I stand with.
Ni Bwana peke yake nisimama naye.
Why are your shoes torn?
Bwana viatu zako zimeraruka.
So when I was coming in the morning, I said, oh, their shoes are torn.
Nilipokuwa nakuja asubuhi nikasema, hey, viatu vyao vimeraruka.
And they have removed their socks and they were looking for their socks. In the front vidole they were stepping down like this as they are walking now. Why are your shoes torn? Listen to this. The nations come here to see this church. They came 49 nations recently. Total about 70 something people, 72 whatever.
Yes.
From abroad. They came to see this church. which is the bride of Christ, the church that has been raised by the Lord, the church that has been preparing for the coming of the Messiah. They came to see. And when they came, what did they see? They were so marveled.
Walishangazwa sana.
They said, wow.
Kusema, wow.
Look at her.
Mtizame yeye.
The royal bride of Christ.
The arusi wa kifalme wa Kristo.
She entered the stadium 3 days before the meeting. Wow.
Anaingia kwenye uwanja wa stadium yake siku tatu kabla ya mkutano. Wow.
Wow, she's worshiping for 3 days. She did not go back home.
Wow, anaabudu siku tatu harudi nyumbani.
3 days, bishop.
Siku tatu askofu.
Three days.
Siku tatu.
Three days non-stop.
Siku tatu pasipo kukoma.
Before the meeting begins.
Kabla ya mkutano kwanza.
I don't know how much energy you need to worship the Lord for 3 days non-stop.
Sijui unahitaji nguvu kiasi gani kuweza kuabudu Bwana siku tatu pasipo kukoma.
The only supernatural energy you need to get. Only that can help you. Otherwise, in the normal world, you need to carry a backpack.
Unahitaji kuwa umebeba mzigo kwa mgongo.
Bag.
Mzigo mfuko kwa mgongo.
And inside there must be bread and scones and sandwiches and Coca-Cola and uji and everything must be there.
Na kila kitu, mkate, soda, Coca-Cola, uji, kila kitu pale ndani.
For you to worship like that.
Ili wewe uweze kuabudu namna hiyo.
And a blanket also.
Na pia blanketi.
For your baby.
Kwa ajili ya mtoto wako.
What they did not carry.
Lakini hawakubeba.
So they came.
Basi wakaja.
They said, wow.
Kasema, wow.
Look at the bride of Christ.
Tizama bi arusi wa Kristo.
Look at how she's worshiping.
Tizama jinsi anabudu.
For 3 days.
Kwa siku tatu.
Before the meeting.
Kabla mkutano.
And they said, this is history being made.
Wakasema, hii ni historia ambayo inatimizwa.
Inatimizwa, inatendwa hapa sa historia.
Ni historia inatengezwa, inatendwa hapa.
How can they worship for 3 days? You know, you can say 3 days.
Unajua naweza sema siku tatu.
And then in the evening you break off.
Alafu jioni ushazimia.
Unaenda nyumbani.
Unaenda nyumbani.
Kukula chakula na kulala vizuri.
Kukula chakula kulala vizuri.
But 3 days and nights.
Lakini siku tatu mchana usiku.
So they came from all over the earth.
Basi walikuja kote kote kutoka ulimwenguni.
They said, wow.
Wow.
Look at her, the bride of Christ.
Tizama yeye ndiye arusi wa Kristo.
Look at how she's worshiping.
Tizama jinsi anabudu.
She's worshiping him.
Yeye anamwabudu yeye.
Wow, she really loves him.
Wow, anampenda hakika.
They looked.
Walitizama.
Number two, they said.
Pili walisema.
When the meeting begins.
Wakati mkutano unaanza.
She still worships for 2 strong days.
Bado anaabudu kwa siku mbili zenye nguvu sana.
Those are 5 days of non-stop worship.
Na hizo ni siku tano za kuabudu pasipo kukoma.
It is not possible, haiwezekani.
Haiwezekani.
You cannot worship like that.
Hawezi kuabudu namna hiyo.
How about your job?
Je, kazi yako?
How about your children?
Na je, kuhusu watoto wako?
How about your cows and goats at home?
Na je, mbuzi zako elfu kule nyumbani?
How about your health?
Na je, kuhusu afya yako?
There are many things that would require you go back home.
Kuna vitu vingi ambavyo zitahitajika kwa kwenda nyumbani.
They came to watch.
Walikuja kuangalia.
Wow.
Wow.
Look at the bride.
Tizama bibi.
Mwambie afanye kitu hivi tumuone. Hey. Wow, thank you my daughter.
Asante binti yangu.
They did like that.
Walifanya hivyo.
Number two.
Pili.
When they saw the dressing of the church.
Wakati waliona vazi la kanisa.
They said, wow, look at how holy she's dressed.
Anasema tazama jinsi amejivika kwa utakatifu.
Wow.
Wow.
She's dressed holy long.
Amejivika kwa utakatifu.
And she lifts her head and she worships. And the little children, her babies are also lifting hands and worshipping. Number three.
Tatu.
They watched.
Wale tizama.
And they said, wow.
Kusama, wow.
Look at how she loves the Lord.
Tizama jinsi anapenda Bwana.
With all her life.
Na maisha yake yote.
And then number four, number five.
Kisha tano.
They also said.
Pia kasema.
Wow.
Wow.
Look at how the Lord loves her back.
Tizama jinsi Bwana anapenda. Kukujibu.
Her cripples are walking.
Her
blind are seeing.
Her
deaf can hear.
Her
mute can speak. Look. Wow. She loves him and he loves her.
Wow. Wanampenda yeye naye anawapenda.
Then they said,
Kisha wakasema,
man of God,
nabii wa Mungu,
can you come to our country, Sweden?
Je, unaweza kuja kwa taifa letu huku Sweden, Uswizi?
Then they cried.
Wakalia.
And then Denmark came also, he said there.
Kisha Denmark wakaja nani pale?
In that house.
Katika hiyo nyumba.
Mudoni allowed us to use this house.
Mudoni akaturuhusu kutumia nyumba yake.
The last day before they left.
Siku ya mwisho kabla hawajaondoka.
And the Denmark wept very bitterly.
Na Denmark wakaja.
Very, very bitterly. It said, can you come to us? And make Denmark like
Kenya.
We want the church in Denmark to also be blessed like Kenya, to be glorious. In Accra, Ghana. They are telling you. That please come help us to organize the meeting for the man of God who is coming, right? Please help, because you are from Kenya, the glorious church. From the glorious church. You have some information we don't have. So please help us sit in our planning meetings. And go to our churches and preach. He goes to churches and preaches, different churches. In Accra, Ghana. To prepare for the meeting of October this year. They say so. Yes,
ma'am. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I visit churches in Ghana.
Natembelea makanisa kule Ghana.
The people of Ghana are looking for this message. They hunger for this message. They have asked the bishop who's organizing the pastors there for the pastors' conference. Has asked me to join them in the arrangements for the meeting. For the man of
God.
And they also allowed me to stand on their pulpits. To share this message.
The message.
You see that? They say, inside us here, there is someone who has come from that revival. Please come and help us, because we want to go exactly the way Kenya went. So we don't make a mistake, so we can be like the Kenya revival, the revival in
Kenya.
Precious people.
Watu wa thamani.
Right now.
Sasa hivi.
Wanyonyi wedded yesterday.
Wanyonyi alifanya harusi jana.
Very glorious wedding.
Harusi ni tukufu sana.
They were engaged, right?
Yes.
They were engaged for some time.
Walikuwa wametubiana kwa muda fulani.
And
kisha
Wanyonyi introduced his wife to be the bride, to be to bishop and to leadership, to me also.
Wanyonyi akitambulisha huyo biarusi wake ambaye atakuwa mke wake kwa askofu, kwa uongozi na kwangu kwa nabii pia.
He brought her here.
Alimleta hapa.
He said, please come. come and meet the man of God first before we marry. I want to introduce you to the man of God.
Akasema tafadhali njoo ukutane na nabii wa Mungu. Kabla hatujaoana, ningependa kutambulisha kwake nabii wa Mungu.
You know, Anyoni is my son.
Unajua Anyoni ni mwanangu.
2004 Kakamega.
Mwaka 2004 Kakamega.
When I went to Kakamega.
You went to Kakamega.
He was a pastor there with those pastors.
Alikuwa ni mchungaji pale na hao wachungaji.
And when I rebuked the sin in the church, and the power of God came and I commanded heaven open and rain poured in Kakamega. And I remember Wanyonyi's clothes were wet.
Look
what happened. Wanyonyi followed me from that day on. Until today. So that is my son. But now listen to this. Finally, after many years, he refused to get married. He said, he wants to serve the Lord.
Hatimaye baada ya miaka mingi akakataa kuoa. Akasema mimi ningependa kumtumikia Bwana.
He said, there is work to do.
Akasema kuna kazi ya kufanya.
I'll marry later, but there is work to do now. There's so much work.
Nikaoa baadaye, lakini sasa kuna kazi ya kufanya. Kuna kazi nyingi sana.
All of you know the way Wanyonyi works in the big meetings.
Wote nyinyi mnajua jinsi Wanyonyi anafanya kazi.
He goes earlier, he sleeps in the night inside the meeting. In the morning he's there, he's our contact person when we're calling in the morning to find the situation on the ground. He's the one feeding us with information. He's the one, he's everything.
Anaenda mapema analala kwa mkutano asubuhi hapo pale kila
wakati usiku hapo pale
usiku hapo
pale mchana hapo pale
mchana hapo pale
yeye ndiye contact person
na tena pia ndiye mtu wetu kwa sinema naye.
Listen,
sikiza.
He found a bride.
Alipata biharusi.
And he touched his heart.
Na yeye akaguza moyo wake.
He came to me here.
Akaja kwangu hapa.
He said, man of God.
Akasema nabii wa Mungu.
I am now quitting the police.
Sasa ninaondoka kufanya kazi kwa polisi.
I am leaving the police.
Ninaacha kazi ya polisi.
And I've told them, I've written a letter. I told them I want to go and serve the Lord only.
Nikawaambia nikawaandikia barua nikawaambia kwamba sasa tumtie Bwana peke yake.
And man of God.
Na nabii wa Mungu.
Now.
Sasa.
I am going to set up a big church.
Nitaenda kuunda kwanza kanisa kubwa.
But you know the way people normally ask.
Lakini unajua kawaida vile watu huuliza.
They might hear that your message is strong.
Wewe utasikia ujumbe wako una nguvu sana.
But they say, but there is one problem with that pastor.
Lakini watasema kuna shida moja na huyo mchungaji.
He is not yet married.
Yeye bado hajaoa.
He spoke to me here.
Alina nami hapa.
Then I said, you are right, my son.
Nikasema huko kwenye haki mwanangu.
To complete your testimony.
Ili uweze kumatikilisha kumatamatisha ushuhuda wako.
If it is the will of the Lord that you be married.
Ikiwa ni mapenzi ya Mungu kwa wewe uoe.
Please, we will support you.
Tafadhali.
And then he found his bride, right?
Kisha akapata biharusi yake sawa.
And he started showing people his bride to take to his friends, to his pastors, bishops, and you know what I'm saying?
Akaanza kupeleka kwa marafiki wake viongozi wa chungaji. Askofu anaita tena nasema.
So we all knew that Wanyonyi has found the bride.
Ingawa basi wote tulijua Wanyonyi amepata biharusi.
And he brought the bride here.
Na ndio biharusi hapa.
Then we knew that everything's well now. I spoke with them and everything else, you know.
Na tukajua kila kitu kiko sawa, ikanena naona kila kitu.
And the wedding was super glorious yesterday.
Na ulikuwa na harusi kwa
kutoka kwa wedding, right?
The most glorious wedding we have ever had. The university senate sent a professor to represent them and speak on their behalf. The OCS of Matu came and invited me that after their honeymoon I can go with Wanyonyi to his home.
Na kani wakanialika ya kwamba baada ya kutoka katika sherehe zao ninaweza kwenda na Wanyonyi katika boma yao.
Majors from the army and colonels of the army, they also attended the wedding.
Ma generali na mabeka kutoka kwa jeshi pia walihudhuria harusi.
The gift, he doesn't need to buy anything in the house. I told you to your tent.
He's saying the gifts that were brought can fill a store.
Sawada wake mwaza niletewa zinaweza kujaza gala.
Bring it just out of joy. I also heard that you are wedding. And we also said we need to present ourselves with something small.
Tukusalimieko kidogo.
Sikia tulisema, tupike hapa tukusalimieko kidogo. Did you understand that?
Ulielewa hayo?
So tell me one thing.
Basi niambie kitu kimoja.
I was holding my breath waiting for him to call me, you know?
Nilikuwa nazuia pumzi yangu nikigoja yeye anipigie simu, unajua?
Everybody in the ministry was anticipating the wedding.
Kila mtu katika huduma hii alikuwa anangojea sana kwa hamu huo hii harusi.
How about?
Je, namna gani?
If after Wanyonyi had taken his bride, shown his bride.
Ikiwa baada ya Wanyonyi ameenda na kuonyesha bi harusi wake,
then news would come to us right before the wedding.
Na habari situfikie sisi kabla tu baada ya harusi.
But do you know what happened?
Kama wanaje nini kitendeka?
The girl,
huyo msichana,
that girl actually dumped Wanyonyi.
Huyo msichana hakika alimkataa Wanyonyi.
And she was seen in the bar drinking with another man.
Na alionekana kwenye kilabu cha pombe akinywa huku na mwanaume mwingine.
And these days,
na siku hizi,
we see her in that man's car.
Tunamwona katika gari ya huyo mwanaume.
Tukimuuliza,
tukimuuliza,
"Je, are you not the lady that was going to wed Wanyonyi?"
Je, wewe si yule mwanamke ambaye alikuwa anaenda kufanya harusi Wanyonyi?
Sema mimi?
Anasema mimi?
I think that's the case of mistaken identity.
Basi naona yeye kukosa kutambua.
Are you not so and so's daughter?
Wewe sio binti ya fulani fulani?
He said, "Yes, I am."
Sema ndio mimi.
Ah, hukusikia habari?
Haukusikia habari?
Hatuko pamoja tena.
Hatuko pamoja tena.
You can imagine me now as his father.
Wewe sasa, Daniel hii, mimi sasa kama baba yake.
I was telling everybody.
Nilikuwa nikiambia kila mtu.
That the way Wanyonyi has stood with the law.
Ya kwamba jinsi Wanyonyi amesimama naye Bwana.
This time that now Wanyonyi needs us.
Wakati sasa ba Wanyonyi sasa anatuhitaji.
We must stand with Wanyonyi.
Lazima tusimame naye Wanyonyi.
I say so.
Nisema hivyo.
But how about if the news was to come?
Lakini je ingekuwa vipi kama habari zingekuja?
And they say, "Oh, the few days for the wedding, that woman jumped out."
Akasema, "Ah, siku chache kabla ya harusi, huyo mwanamke aliruka tu."
You can imagine the many people that kept the university senate. It was already announced in the university senate, in the senate of the professors. The big names of Safaricom that came. So the issue is this, it was already announced. How about? Now if they had found that after they were preparing, the woman has jumped out. She's playing. You know the busaba. She's dancing there, she's drunk. She's sleeping. She's dancing there, she's sleeping. Any man is dancing there.
Mwanaume yote anacheza naye tu pale.
Leo ni gapi mchezo imeanza?
Leo ni gapi mchezo imeanza?
Nani
atacheza na huyu msichana?
50 bob.
I'm seeing two.
Ah, mimi naweka 100.
Mimi naweka 100.
Ah, yule ameshinda ameweka 150, yeye anacheza na yeye.
Yule anashinda ameweka 150 ndio anacheza na yeye.
And the girl herself is drunk, it's 10 a.m.
Na msichana mwenyewe amelewa. Ni saa
4
asubuhi.
Tayari amelewa busa.
Tayari amelewa busa.
And Wanyonyi was waiting.
Now Wanyonyi alikuwa anangojea.
The university student was waiting.
University student alikuwa anangojea.
Safaricom was waiting.
Safaricom alikuwa anangojea.
The majors and the colonels of the army were prepared.
Na meja na majenerali wa jeshi walikuwa anangojea wamejiandaa.
The ministry leadership, everybody was prepared.
Na uongozi wa huduma kila mtu alikuwa anajiandaa.
150,000 shillings food only.
Yes.
Put down for food, top chefs. Top chefs were pulled from hotels from where?
Wapishi wakuu walitolewa kutoka hoteli na kila mahali.
And then they say last minute.
Na wanasema dakika ya mwisho.
Hukujua?
Hukujua.
Si ndio huyo hapo kwa hiyo baya kusamelewa hata sasa hizo kiondo one.
Ndio huyo kwa baya kusamelewa
hata sasa. Hata tuweza sasa hizo tumuona hapo si anacheza sasa hizo hapa kwa baya busa.
Sasa huyo tumuona anacheza pale kwa busa.
The guitar now.
Anacheza guitar sasa.
He's beat not the records of guitar, those records.
Unajeza rekodi za gita.
Za gita.
Za gita.
Zinacheza kwa hiyo bar.
Zinacheza kwa hiyo bar.
10 a.m. she's drunk.
Na ni saa 4 ya asubuhi ni mlevi.
What would we have done?
Tungefanya nini?
Especially this ministry.
Hasa sana katika huduma hii.
Aibu kubwa kiasi gani ingetukula?
Ni aibu kubwa kiasi gani ambayo ingetula sisi?
Because when Wanyonyi left the other churches, the other fake false bishops.
Kwa sababu wakati Wanyonyi alitoka yale makanisa mengine, wale askofu badia, wengo.
Now they were watching, how are they going to treat his wedding?
Sasa walikuwa wanaangalia, watafanyaje kwa harusi yake?
Now the Lord has brought the nations here.
Sasa Bwana ameleta mataifa hapa.
To see the bride of Christ.
Wana harusi wa Kristo.
Huh? He is telling them, come see my bride. I want to introduce you to my bride.
Anasema, join. Mwana harusi wangu, ningependa niwatambulishe kwa harusi yangu.
Can you please see my bride?
Tazama mwana harusi wangu.
Look how she is holy.
Tazama jinsi alivyo mtakatifu.
Look how she loves me.
Tazama jinsi ananipenda.
That is what Wanyonyi was showing us.
Ndio Wanyonyi alikuwa anatuonyesha.
He was bringing her, he said, let them sit together. And before they talk, they look at each other. In other words, look at how she loves me. Look at how we love each other. But tell me one thing. The nations are anticipating. They want to be like Kenya. And they say that is the perfect bride. She worships on Monday, on Tuesday she's worshiping, Wednesday and Friday, although she has no job.
Na sema wewe ndiye harisi mkamilifu, anaabudu Jumatatu, Jumanne, Jumatano, hata Ijumaa kana kwamba hana kazi.
She's worshiping. Look at the one sitting here.
Anaabudu tazama aliyeketi hapa.
Today is what? Today is a Monday, it's a holiday. You should be doing barbecue outside. In fact, if you go out, you find families on barbecue. You should be there with your children, barbecue, soda. Nani weka soda baridi? Funika hiyo fridge, nini ice na soda. Nani, jirani, barbecue, na mambo inatendeka. Today.
Leo.
You should be doing that.
Wastahili kufanya hayo.
But you are not there.
Lakini haukuwa pale.
You are sitting in the presence of the Lord.
Ulikuwa umeketi katika uwepo wa Bwana.
To receive the pastor of the Lord.
Kupokea shauri la Bwana.
You are here to receive the counsel of the Lord.
Uko hapa kupokea shauri.
And he said, if I receive this, it's better than diamond and silver and gold.
Unasema nikipokea hili ni bora kuliko almasi.
Listen to this. The Lord has presented his bride to the nations.
Bwana ameleta harusi yake kwa mataifa.
He has shown the nations who his bride is, how she looks like.
Ameonyesha mataifa harusi yake inaonekana namna gani.
How about if they will hear?
Na je kama watasikia?
That bride we saw.
Ule harusi tuliyemwona.
Do you know what happened?
Na je nini natendeka?
There is sexual sin in the worship.
Kuna washerati katika kundi la kuabudu.
Yeah.
Ndio.
The young men are sleeping with the young girls in the worship there.
Vijana wanaume wanalala vijana sana katika kundi cha ibada pale.
The pastors have fallen, they're preaching money, they are corrupt.
Na wachungaji wameanguka pia wanahubiri pesa wanakidhani.
The pastors are preaching and lusting at girls.
Wachungaji wanahubiri na kutamani mapenzi wasichana.
What will the nations do?
Je, mataifa yatafanya nini?
Because they said.
Kwa sababu walisema.
That finally they found the true message.
Ya kwamba hatimaye walipata ujumbe wa kweli.
The true messenger.
Na ujumbe wa kweli.
The true miracles.
Na miujiza za kweli.
The true miracles.
Na miujiza za kweli.
The true signs and wonders.
Na ishara na maajabu ya kweli.
Finally they found the true revival.
Hatimaye walipata ujumbe wa kweli.
In Venezuela you heard about the earthquake.
Kule Venezuela ulisikia kuhusu tetemeko la ardhi.
You heard, right? Oh, wow, how could you hear? No, this is Nairobi.
Nairobi, how could you hear?
What do you want to hear? What?
Yes.
Well, Nairobi, what?
Yes.
Okay, but I see you hear Sauti Kubwa.
Yes.
Okay, you see that?
Wana haya?
So everything is right. Even when the messenger comes, and he warns them and says, to prove to you that the prophet of the Lord has been here, the Lord is going to shake Venezuela a little bit to prove to you that the prophet of the Lord has walked here, has stood here. And in 24 hours, the Lord shook
Venezuela.
Listen, precious people. The message is right. The messenger is right. The miracles are right. The signs of wonders are right. And they say, please come to us. Angola, I saw their message yesterday from Dr. Makwengo. He said, Kenya has had the man of God for 7 years. So they've heard him. Kenya. And he said,
Nagasema.
For us, we want him to come. We want to give him a visa for 6 months. 6 months visa.
Visa ya miezi sita.
We want to give him a visa of 6 months.
Tunataka kupatia yeye visa ya miezi sita.
Because only 6 months we need and our revival will be greater than Kenya's.
Kwa sababu ni miezi sita tu tunahitaji na ugonjwa wetu utakuwa mkubwa sana kupita ule wa Kenya.
In fact, they said literally every living person walking the land of Venezuela will be born again. Whoever walking the land of Angola will be born again.
Hakika ukasema halisi mtu yote ambaye anatembea katika nchi ya Angola ataokoka hata zaidi mara ya pili.
How about
Niger?
If they now hear, that do you know that servant of the Lord? The one we are waiting for. He has fallen such a sin. And is now in prosperity and preaching money and everything, you know. His message is broken. He has fallen. That's, forget it. Even his prophecies are false now. How about if they were to hear that? How broken hearted would they be? In fact, they will say, in fact, Nigeria, did you see the email from Nigeria? From the Secretary General of PFN? Yes. The Secretary General for the Pentecostal Fellowship Network, he sent an email saying, man of God, I want to report this. Your message you brought here has changed Nigeria now. Because now we are doing state-wise meetings, full state of all pastors in the state, and different Christian organizations are coming, and they are receiving the message, and they are repenting.
Kwa sababu sasa tunafanya mikutano ya wachungaji ya maeneo na wanakuja kutoka maeneo tofauti tofauti wanapokea wanatubu.
They are receiving this message.
Wanapokea ujumbe huu.
They are repenting.
Wanatubu.
And they are now beginning to change their preaching.
Na sasa wanaanza kubadilisha mahubiri yao.
Before after when I get the message.
Ninapopata ujumbe.
When I get the message.
Nilipotoa ule ujumbe.
At the big Pentecostal Fellowship Network of Nigeria.
Katika ushirika mkuu wa Pentecostal Network ya Nigeria.
The South to South geopolitical zone ile ya kusini.
Na ile maeneo ya kusini na kusini.
And so when I get the message there was a very very top evangelist, the global evangelist of Nigeria.
Kulikuwa na evangelist wa juu sana wa kidunia wa Nigeria.
Who was now going to give a talk after me. And he came in a Rolls Royce. Is it Rolls Royce. The top car in a Rolls Royce. Rolling the Royals. Is that the word? Is that the meaning of that? Rolls Royce, eh? Even his door doesn't open like this, the door opened like this, didn't you? And so he came. I thank God he came and sat in the meeting as I was giving this message. Did they call him Opai? They say he goes globally. These are definitely people with aircrafts. Ndege za kuruka na kwenda. So now he sat there. He came with a message. But after I finish this message of fire,
lakini baada ya kukumalizia ujumbe huu wa moto,
I told my team, let us leave from the altar. They out, we went. Now,
sasa,
the secretary general, you saw the email.
Ule katibu mkuu uliona ujumbe wake.
He said he fumbled.
Anasema yeye alishindwa kuli.
He did not have a message.
Hakuwa na ujumbe.
After that message.
Baada ya ujumbe huo.
And they say, then they began preaching a similar message now. He just now saying, yes, repentance, in fact, there's corruption in Nigeria, in the church, you know, all that, you know. The devil is biting us because of corruption in the church. That is the message the Lord gave. Prepare, the Messiah is coming. He had no choice. But his message was dismantled. So tell me one thing. With all this fire and power. And then they hear, you know what? He fell. In fact, I've seen myself going to Nigeria, get taking flights to Nigeria twice now. And they're putting big billboards in the big entrance to big towns. Prepare the way the Messiah is coming. Repent, turn away from sin. You see that? How about if they hear this messenger failed to women and sexual sin and money and nonsense and everything else? Ndani ya ngono na wanawake na nini na uongo na wote nonsense yote.
Jay,
what will happen to their hearts? It will be broken. That is the same thing that will happen to Christ. If he hears that there is sexual sin in the worship, in this church, in this ministry, that is the same thing that will happen to the Lord. Remember, I said, Wanyonyi is my son. And for a long time we held him, we tended him. And we saw he was not marrying. And I, at one point I thought maybe he had decided to serve the Lord alone. And now, when now he says he wants to marry, I even told him something. I told him, Wanyonyi, maybe you don't even know how to love now. And the Lord has to help you to love your wife now. Because you've lived alone. I was doing counseling with them here. And the thing is this, when now everything was going well, you can imagine how I was holding my breath for my son. How about if I was here that she broke his heart and jumped out? How about if God the Father, after seeing how powerful Jesus has worked in the crusades, in the morning is there, in the evening the Lord is always there, in the night when we call him, he gives us the report of what's happening, and the Father has seen how faithful he has worked alone, and know that his day is now coming, and the entire heaven is marshalling resources, and every effort directed towards here, and the breath is held. And then you hear that the church he was showing in Kenya, she has fallen to sexual sin. How much broken hearted would the father be? Did you understand me? For me, I cannot fall because the nations are waiting. And the Messiah must come. And I've decided I will not fall. For me, I cannot fall. Because if I try, the Lord will slash my neck. For me, I cannot fall. Because I love him too much. Tell me. You too, you cannot fall. Did you understand me? So if you have been sitting in that church looking at some girls fooling around you, oh lawyer, you're a lawyer, advocate, that thing should end, right? You are pastor and advocate. You know, pastor, I want you to counsel me. I have some issues I want to talk about them with you. If you were having those doubts, today is the day to take a knife and cut. Just like I cannot fall, you cannot fall. Because Bwana tayari asha sambaza, asha tangaza.
Bwana asha tangaza tayari.
Jo onene bijaruzi wangu.
Jo mwona bijaruzi wangu.
Vila nabana utakatifu.
Jinsi anajivika kwa utakatifu.
Anababudu kwa utakatifu.
Anabudu kwa utakatifu.
Anaubiri utakatifu.
Anaubiri utakatifu.
Ananipenda na utakatifu.
Ananipenda na utakatifu.
Anatembea na utakatifu.
Anatembea na utakatifu.
Maisha yake ni utakatifu.
Maisha yake ni utakatifu.
She is the hope of heaven.
Yeye ndiye tumaini la mbingu.
All over the earth.
Kote kote duniani.
Wherever I have gone to the Western Hemisphere, now I'm headed to Vietnam on this side. Wherever I've gone, Australia South, all the way to up Sweden, I have not found a nation that is preparing for the coming of the Messiah.
Popote nimeenda, popote nimeenda, na jana kupiga kwa kimesihi.
Only Kenya I found.
Ni Kenya pekee yake nilipata. Niambie.
And the other church out there, you know what's going on there.
Unajua nini inaendelea pale?
The big churches out here. Even small ones, whatever.
Hata zile ndogo zote hizo.
You know what's happening in these churches, isn't it?
Mbona nini inaendelea kwa kanisa hizo?
Panda mbegu ubarikiwe, panda mbegu upate nini, whatever the nonsense, right? And the last of women, and if you look at the way the women dress and say, are you working with the Holy Spirit? Oh me, I am filled with the Holy Spirit. But if you were filled, talk to me, translate this. You find the Christians.
Unapata wa Kristo.
Can you do this? Thank you, my son. You find Christians.
Unapata wa Kristo.
And they, I said, my daughter, they come to me in the streets. They come to me.
Unapata kwangu mitani.
And they say, oh man of God, how are you?
Wanasema nabii wa Mungu uhali gani?
I'm glad to meet you today for the first time.
Nafurahi sana kukutana nawe leo mara ya kwanza.
And I ask my daughter, are you born again?
Na wewe binti yangu, wewe mzee
mara ya born again?
Nasema mimi ni mzee mara ya pili.
And are you filled with the Holy Spirit?
Na je, umejaa na Roho Mtakatifu?
Oh, I am filled with the Holy Ghost.
Mimi nimejaa na Roho Mtakatifu.
But the question is this.
Swali ni hili.
When you look at her,
unapomtazama yeye,
the breast is naked.
Matiti yake yako uchi.
The trouser is tight.
Na trouser yake imemguza mpana.
Or maybe the skirt has a slit or it is short, whatever the case.
Ama skirt yake ni vupi ama iko na mkato, chochote kile.
And she's walking.
Na yeye anatembea kwa madaha.
And then I ask myself.
Kisha nikajiuliza binafsi.
If you truly are filled of the Holy Ghost.
Ikiwa hakika kanisa umejazwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
The river that flows from behind the throne room of God.